Yo, what's up everyone?
In this video, I want to talk about broad and russet mites and what you can do when you have them, because I personally dealt with them for a long time because I first didn't know what they really were, and that's the problem that most people have. It kind of looks like some type of deficiency, and so it can take a few grows until you really know what they are. And the problem is they are so small, you can't really see them with your naked eye. So you should get a microscope, a good microscope, and check on the stems. I found that they lay their eggs inside of stems and inside of the leaves, and you can find them underneath the leaves if you look closely with a microscope, or on the stems of your plants. So first make sure that that you really have them and it's not another issue. They are a lot worse than spider mites. You can't really even compare it. Spider mites are quite easy to get rid of if you compare it with broad or russet mites, and russet mites are even worse than broad mites. So let me tell you the things that work and the things that don't work, because I found some misinformation on the internet. Things that don't work: neem oil. Let me tell you that this doesn't work because it's harsh on your plants. It will kill more your plants more than they actually might. And the problem is they become resistant for neem oil. So I found it a waste of money. It doesn't work on broad or russet mites. It will work on maybe on spider mites, and like if you have aphids or things like that, or like some flies or small bugs. But on mites it doesn't work. Second thing that doesn't work: insecticidal soap. But I mean, the problem is they also become resistant. And it's just not good enough, and it doesn't kill the eggs. It might turn them down a little, but it won't kill the eggs. That's the problem. But what I did find that works is an insectal soap with pyrethrin inside of it. But I will put some links in the description. Check it out, to products that to things that work. So if you have one with pyrethrin inside, it's a good idea. But otherwise, don't get insecticidal soap. And the thing is with all these products, you have to rotate them, because if you spray one type of product, they will become resistant. They become resistant to almost everything, except for a few products that I will talk about later. So then you have predatory mites, which are mites that can that like to eat them. But the problem is with those predatory mites is I tried it, and it works if you do it after the treatment. So first you do a chemical treatment, or like with some natural pesticides, and then afterwards you let predatory mites inside your grow room to control, basically to control that there won't be an outbreak anymore. It's more like something you do afterwards. You won't get rid of them with only predatory mites. You can try, but I tried, and really I let like 200 predatory mites per plant, and it didn't work. Now I'm going to tell you some things that actually work. First thing is, and you don't see this, talk about, not many people talk about this online, but you have to mix some aspirin, just normal aspirin. You mix it in your water, and then you give it to your plants. And the thing is, it will boost their immune system, and it really works well. But the aspirin itself won't let you get rid of broad or russet mites. But the thing is, like, your plants will be stronger, and they won't be affected as much by the poison that the broad and russet mites inject into your plants, because this is the difference, like with spider mites or things or other bugs. Broad and russet mites, they attack your plants by spraying some type of poison inside of your plants. And if you mix aspirin in your water, your plants can like fight it off better. But like in 2 days, 2 3 days, you will see the difference if you give some aspirin to your plants. But like I said, I mean, it's something that you like an some extra for the treatment. I mean, because it won't solve the problem. It's just like to boost their immune system. Anyway, next we have spinosad. It works, but you should rotate it with a few other products. Then we have rosemary oil, which is cheap. You can get it quite cheap, and you mix it with water. And I found it a lot better than neem oil for fighting specific broad and russet mites. And it's not as harsh on your plants like neem oil. Then we have Essentia IC3, which is a very good product. Also, I would rotate it with a few other things. Mighty Wash, this is like, I think, the number one product to fight these types of mites. I found it working very well. And I love Mighty Wash for also for rotation. If you spray another product, then you do a wash with Mighty Wash. But the thing is, like, you have to spray every day. I mean, broad mites and russet mites, they are like the worst thing that can happen to a grower. And you have to go nuclear war with them. Otherwise, they will keep coming back. It's really a pain in the ass. So you have to spray every day. Keep your grow room very clean. It has to be like a hospital. You should be able to eat from the floor. Two things that work very well. These are actually the best products, but the thing is, they are quite harsh, and you can't smoke it anymore if you use these two products. But that's kind of the problem with all these insecticides. You should at least water cure the weed, but I wouldn't even use it. It's better if you like do a grow and treatment, and then wait to the next grow. I wouldn't consume it if you use a lot of pesticides. Anyway, two things that work very well are Avid and 4-Bite. But they are quite toxic, so that's kind of the downside from using these two products. But really, like I said, I mean, these things are quite hard to get rid of. Just some neem oil won't do the job. It's not some aphids or things like that that you're dealing with. These things are really serious. And I mean, like even how they lay their eggs, like I said, they put their eggs in the stems or the leaves, and that's also one of the problems. Because these eggs grow inside of your plants, and also the fact that they inject some poison in your plants, you can see your plants go from perfectly healthy to like near death in maybe a week time or 2 weeks time. That's how worse these things are. And once you notice the outbreak, it's already too late, you could say, unless you go immediately nuclear war with them. But then you have the problem that if you use these harsh chemicals, it's not really healthy anymore to consume. But it's the only way to get rid of them. Or you will deal with it for like years to come. They won't go away out of their self. So if you're interested in this product, I will put a link in the description. Especially like the aspirin is also a very good idea. But like I said, it's more of a health booster for your plants, but you will see them become healthy again in a few days time. It really works well for this application. And after you used all these treatments, you can let some predatory mites loose on them, on your plants, so to prevent, basically. Anyway, thanks for watching. I hope you learned some things. Have a good day. Bye.